Last week, 20 seasons of Survivor led up to our most epic battle yet. Rob Mariano, one of the game's ultimate strategists and also one of the biggest double dealers, had recreated himself as a hero.
A lot has happened with me personally in my life in the 6 years since I've played this game. I'm learning compromise and patience.
He led his tribe of villains by being a straight shooter and working hard.
I'm in awe of Rob. You are the man, and it's like when you talk, I'm literally hanging on every word.
I appreciate it.
Because of his efforts, the tribe flourished.
Rob jumps down on the final piece! Villains win immunity!
But he made an enemy of Russell.
Watch your back, man.
Yeah, yeah, same thing for you, man.
Who used lies, intimidation, and chaos to further his own self-interest.
I'm that good. Well, I could bring people together in this game for my good.
So Rob's leadership was short-lived.
My idea of trust and loyalty is different from Russell's.
Motivated by jealousy, Russell used his power of persuasion and gathered enough votes to eliminate his adversary.
Rob.
The loss of Rob has given the heroes a chance at a comeback. Now they're down only two members. And they've even discovered a clue to a hidden immunity item.
We're gonna look for it together.
But the bigger question, how will losing Rob's leadership and challenge dominance impact the villain tribe?
The waters are so muddy right now. I mean, we were in the best position possible.
Coach, Courtney, and Sandra refused to vote for Rob, and now they're trapped in a tribe controlled by Russell, whose ego may have just put the villains in a hole they can't get out of.
Russell is always plotting and scheming. You just don't want the guy around. You know he's gonna do everything he can to backstab you.
He's in the tent with his concubines and does nothing. He's like a black hole, you know, sucking in energy and light, everything.
It's just a sickness almost. It's like, it's a huge black cloud over everything we do. I mean, he does nothing to help at camp.
He could be worse than Johnny Fairplay. He is.
I'll go tally the votes. If you have the hidden immunity idol around your neck and you want to play it, tonight is the last time you can do so.
You know what, Jeff? I think I'm going to keep it for a souvenir.
Okay, once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted out will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately.
Really, because I'm the weakest one. I'm hanging by a thread.
So what's the plan? I'm sure they want me.
Yes, but... I'm gonna change it.
Promise me?
Yeah, I promise you.
Okay. I trusted you and only you from the first day, so.
If it was you, I'd tell you right now.
I know.
Just like I told you earlier, it might be.
I'm trying to keep Natalie because she's holding on my coattails. Who better to take the final two than her? There's no way she can beat me in votes.
Russell, this hurts me. We got nothing in common. You played an unethical game. Admittedly played an unethical game. The crazy thing about it is, you're sitting there. I'm standing here. Did you get to the right place by behaving the wrong way? I've never been in a situation in my entire life where that was the case. But you sit there proud of it. Natalie, people will call you weak. People will say that you are undeserving. But you know what? Why are those characteristics any less admirable as lying, cheating, and stealing? Why does he get a free pass, but your wrong way of playing is admonished? If there's one thing that I learned in this game, it is that perception is not reality. Reality is reality, and you are sitting there, and that makes you just as dangerous as any one of those guys there. You would say that you were probably the least deserving of the title of sole survivor. But maybe, just maybe, in an environment filled with arrogance, delusional entitlement, maybe the person who thinks that she's least deserving is probably the most. You got my vote. I hope you get four more. Congratulations.
The winner of Survivor Samoa, Natalie.
I'll tell you how I think the vote is going to go. Jambo, Dave, Brett, John, Eric, that's five. I am another millionaire.
Congratulations.
Yeah, what I can promise you is me and you will be in the top three.
Okay.
Have a seat, man.
Yeah.
So, if you win it, then you're safe, of course. If I win it, I'll take you to the top three. If you win, we're in top three. We have no doubts. I'm going to do it straight up with you. Deal.
Deal.
Top three.
Legitimate.
I'm real on this.
I'm real, too.
Okay.
It's a big one.
You got to have some kind of insurance policy in this game. If he keeps winning, I got to save myself. Number one uno here. I take care of me. I don't take care of nobody else in this game.
Brett falls off. Russell wins individual immunity, his first, and it couldn't have come at a better time.
Chop.
Russell, come on over.
This is the time I wanted it.
Russell wins the final individual immunity challenge. You are going to the final tribal council. You will get a chance to plead your case in front of the jury as to why you deserve $1 million. Natalie, Mick, Brett, one of you going home tonight. Your shot at $1 million will come to an end. Grab your stuff, head back to camp. See you at tribal tonight.
I won immunity today. This is worth $1 million right now. In my opinion, I just won the game.
Fifteenth person voted out, and the ninth and final member of our jury, Brett. He'd bring me your torch.
Nice.
Brett, the tribe has spoken.
Again, guys.
Bye, Brett.
Thanks for the adventure.
Every single person on this team is an idiot. I'm furious. This whole stupid thing, packing up the whole camp, just assuming there's going to be a merge. Are you kidding me? You know, voting off Rob was a big mistake. He would have made sure that Sandra and Courtney did not sit out today, that they played, and that we had strong people in the immunity challenge.
Do you want to get even with Coach? Think about it. Russell's the kind of person where if he finds out somebody's gunning for him, he'll take them out. If one of us is going next, we could put a bug in his ear that Coach is gunning for him. I'll be like, hey, Russell, Coach wants you gone, and I bet you Russell will believe me and get rid of Coach, and me and Courtney will be saved again.
I'm going to work my magic, and we're both going to be here on day 22 and day 23.
She's over there talking to Coach.
To Courtney?
Yeah.
Oh.
But it don't matter what she says. I will tell them this is how we're voting, and that's how it is going to be. That simple.
But at the same time, I heard Coach was saying that he made a mistake and he wish he could go back.
What mistake?
In letting Rob go home. That he should have never made the choice that he made and that he's sorry. That's what he told her. And that he wanted to get rid of you. So, I don't know about your homeboy.
Oh, he ain't my homeboy. I don't trust him, obviously. You can't trust him. Because of that right there. He's going behind my back saying stuff like that. You know, he's digging his own grave just like Rob did.
I told Russell that Coach was talking about voting for him. And Russell's so stupid. He ate that crap up. I'm telling you, he's like, oh my God, I can't trust him. And the story was the best. So, Russell, he don't know how to play this game. Yeah, he's done good so far. But with me, he don't know what he got himself into.
Ninth person voted out a survivor, heroes versus villains, and the first member of our jury. Good thing you're torch.